UAW, you saved the automobile industry back in 2008 and before. You made a lot of sacrifices. You gave up a lot, and the companies were in trouble. But now they're doing incredibly well. And guess what? You should be doing incredibly well, too. It's a simple proposition.
Yes, sir.
15 years ago, our economy nearly collapsed.
It was the worst day on Wall Street.
Millions of people lost their homes. Millions more lost their life savings.
I think the foreclosure crisis began as a problem for mostly lower income households. It's now a problem for all households.
The American auto industry was on the brink.
In the midst of a financial crisis and a recession, allowing the U.S. auto industry to collapse is not a responsible course of action.
And the American auto worker sacrificed almost everything. The deal was UAW members take some short-term cuts for the long-term survival of Ford, General Motors, and Chrysler. That's the promise we made. And that's the promise that was broken.
I personally went 12 years without a raise, without any additional benefits to allow the company to become profitable.
And were it not for those concessions that we made, the auto industry in the United States would not exist as we know it today.
They slashed our wages. They killed our pensions. They took our retiree health care. They closed plants, killed jobs, destroyed communities, destroyed lives. They wrecked our economy. And they built a new economy. In their economy, the CEOs get everything and the working class gets nothing.
You've seen a 34% pay increase in your salary. You make almost $30 million. Why should your workers not get the same type of pay increases that you're getting?
In their economy, workers live paycheck to paycheck while Wall Street gets another stock buyback. In their economy, we make all the sacrifice, and they take all the profit. They want to use scare tactics, saying we're going to wreck the economy. We're not going to wreck the economy. We're going to wreck their economy, the one that only works for the billionaire class. The big three automakers took our cutbacks and concessions all the way to the bank. In the past 10 years, they've made $250 billion. Car prices are through the roof. CEO salaries are to the moon. Meanwhile, our standard of living has dropped like a rock. Our work-life balance is a joke. Our retirement security is a myth. We sacrificed everything, and we were never made whole.
No pay!
No parts!
No pay!
No parts!
No pay!
No parts!
No pay!
No parts!
They promised that if we stepped up to save the auto industry, our time would come. They broke that promise, so we're making a new promise. We promise that this time, we're not making all the sacrifice so the big three can take all the profit. We promise that this time, we're not letting the billionaires get everything while the working class gets the scraps. We promise we will stand up and stand together for what we deserve.